Hello everybody, this is Simon with the 7th episode of Let's Play Mega Man 4. Only two remaining, so whom will I pick? Drill or Bright? Well, I saved two of the worst levels for last, so I think I'll get the one I hate most out of the way first. It's off to Brightman, who has to win the award for most retarded looking robot master in this game easily. With Toadman in the competition, that says a lot. Also, damn is the stage pink and damn is the music shitty. I really don't like anything about this. So hey, who are you? Fireworks student! Oh. It's dark now? Now it's light. Meet the main gimmick of this level. It's not too hard to understand really, but it has its trickery, and the trickery is exactly here. Oh wait, there is a jump here, right? Well, where the hell does the ledge end? Better not kill the guy here, huh? Fortunately, he will respawn and it will get bright again. Thing with the respawn is, of course, well, we'll have to deal with him again, so like that. Now this jump here, this jump is the ender of lives. I think it has cost more game overs than any other jump in the whole game. Because, look at this, once you go back just a little bit, the dude on the right will respawn. Even if you make this asshole jump here, you will still fall down because he knocks you off. This is bullshit, I hate it. This is the worst thing ever. And I think I have died to this jump alone a lot of times too. So totem poles, huh? Why don't we pick out Ring Boomerang? Ring Boomerang is a relatively short range weapon, which will never ever get destroyed by hitting anything. This is its main purpose, because this way you can hit enemies twice with it, and it will also pierce shields. Well, Dust Crusher is not exactly suited to that. If you time it just right, it can, and will, destroy those totem poles in the right amount of time. But, well, it seems like a secondary shot didn't hit there or anything. Still, it is not that bad, but there is a better option to deal with them. As you also may have noticed, those guys jump when prompted by you going near them. Meaning that you cannot easily go over them with the balloon item. We will try to do this later though, but they obviously thought of that. Treachery. So, Ring Boomerang is really good against many enemies because it hits twice, but its normal power isn't all that great as it wins here because this guy here will actually take two shots. And if the return doesn't hit, it's somewhat quirkier in its physics, then, well, you're shit out of luck. Still, as said, it's not too bad, you just have to use it in the right spots. Generally though, those spots are few and far between because Dust Crusher just deals more damage and it also shoots forward. So what do we have here? This is the secondary gimmick of this stage and it's, well, kind of shitty. Those platforms here have extremely quirky physics. Just like that, you might have noticed that I jumped higher than usual there, because, similarly to Yoshi's Island, when you get off them at the right moment, they will give you extra momentum for your jump. This is just about the only time in all of Mega Man where you have this momentum, and, well, it's confusing to say the least. Those jumps here are, as you winced before, doable with a slight jump, but not doable if you edge forward. Well, maybe they are, but it's really, really close then. So, this secondary area is relatively obviously designed to get the E-Tank and the life, then sacrifice yourself, because there is no way you're going back there. Why they couldn't have made all platforms green is beyond me. So, just like that, balloon. You have to go really high to clear this one. But it works, it does work. It just creates atrocious amounts of slowdown, but whatever. So the better way to deal with those guys, unload a charged Mega Buster and then fire away. This way you won't have any trouble. I personally do not mind the grasshopper sections too much. They are okay in my book, but I know that many people have trouble with them too, so this whole stage is just trouble for everyone around. I don't think there is one guy in the whole world who likes every part of that. So, the last part is my personal trouble spot. What we have here, first of all, it will be in the dark, which doesn't matter too much because you will see the platform still if you take out the light guy, but I like racing the light on the bottom. It should not be any problem if you just wing it forward like that, and well, I wanted to slide here, but fucked up the timing. I may make it look easy, but the physics on those platforms are hard as hell to control. And this guy here is a dick move. If you have not a skull shield equipped or do not hit him with a perfectly timed buster shot, he will knock you off, and it sucks, because it's right at the end and you will have to redo a lot of things. Just for demonstration purposes, yeah, the physics on those things are kind of borked if you hit them at the wrong point, if you jump too early, too late. I really do not like it. So, charging up, not a good idea at first against Brightman. Why? We'll see. Also, jumping through boss doors will give you an extra boost forward. It's mostly not useful, but someone wanted me to show it off, and I did. So, first order of business is not to get cornered like I just did. Second order of business is always just shoot a single jump, shoot a shot and then charge up all the time. Like I did not do it now. You might have noticed that I shot him by accident normally because he's too big for the shot to clear him. This will bite me in the ass right about now, because he will activate his flash stopper and then jump into you 50% of the time, and there is not a goddamn thing you can do about it. If he activates his flash stopper, it's all about luck. He will either shoot you or jump into you. If he jumps into you, deals tremendous amounts of damage and absolutely no way to avoid it. This sucks balls. So the way to do it is obviously not letting me use the flash stopper ever. How do you do this, you might ask? Well, as said, hit him with a normal jump and then just charge up all the time, constantly. Because he will only activate his flash stopper at fixed intervals when his life hits a certain total. Please jump, thank you very much. So, if you always do this, he will never activate his flash stopper. This is the only way to consistently deal with this fight, and it's absolutely unintuitive. How the hell are you supposed to figure this out? I don't get it. Brightman sucks. He sucks so much balls. I hate him, his stage, everything about it. Sorry for ranting, but finally it's done. Flash Stopper, on the other hand, is a nice bonus to get, because Flash Stopper breaks this game in half so many times. I opted to get it last because, almost last, because I didn't want to make it too easy on myself. Maybe I'll make a bonus video to show off what exactly it can do. We'll see about that later. For now, only one guy remaining, we will see it in action here. This was Simon, and thank you very much for your attention.